Hi folks, hope you're okay today. It's good to be with you. The Bible calls the blood of Jesus Christ precious. That it's precious blood. Precious blood. Many people have gone to the mountains in the Klondike in years gone by to look for gold and pan for gold, and they've wasted their lives trying to just get a bit of gold. There are people who've tried their best to become millionaires and done everything they can to be millionaires. And there are people who buy lottery tickets in the hope to be millionaires. But I want to tell you something that's more, something more precious than being rich. There's something more precious than gold. There's something more precious than diamonds. And that is the blood of Jesus Christ. For the blood of Jesus Christ is the blood of God. It says in the book of Acts, the blood of God. That God shed his blood on the cross. When he shed his blood, he shed that blood on that cross. It was precious blood. More precious than gold. More precious than diamonds. When he shed his blood on that cross, it was the precious blood of God. He shed his blood on that cross. The mighty Son of God, who knew no sin, who done no wrong, who never lied and never stole, who lived a perfect life. He was holy and pure, and he was the perfect lamb, the perfect sacrifice for you and me. It was the blood of God. It was the blood of God shed for you. The blood of God was on the cross. The blood of God died on that cross. And the blood of God shed his blood that you may live and go to heaven and not hell. But if I put £1 million in front of you, if I put a pile of diamonds in front of you, if I put a gold bar in front of you, what would you do? If I put a load of diamonds in front of you, if I put a load of gold in front of you, and said, here, you can have the gold, you can have the diamonds, what would you do? You'd grab the diamonds, you'd grab the gold. Well, God has given you something more precious than gold, more precious than diamonds. He's given you his Son, Jesus Christ. His Son, Jesus Christ, who shed his blood and went to that cross and gave his life. There in the courtyard they whipped him. There in the courtyard they spat at him. And when they whipped him, when they spat at him, he was taking it for you. He was taking the whipping. He was taking the humiliation for you. When he stood there with a crown of thorns on his head, and they put a robe round him, they hit him in the face and said, prophesy, who hit you in the face? And when he took that humiliation, he was taking that humiliation for you on that cross. Then he had to carry the cross and he couldn't carry it. Someone had to carry it with him. Then they got him to Golgotha, and there they nailed one hand, they nailed another hand, and then they nailed his feet. And when they nailed him and they lifted him up, it was the blood of God. It was the Messiah. It was Yeshua. It was the King of Kings and Lord of Lords dying on that cross, shedding his blood, dying on that cross to save you from the wrath to come. There is a wrath to come. There is a hell and a judgment to come. God said one day there'll be a day of judgment. Paul said, in which he will judge the world in righteousness. There will be a day of judgment where every man, woman and child will come before the living God, and all of us will have to give an account before Almighty God. It doesn't matter how rich you are then. It doesn't matter how much gold you have. It doesn't matter how many savings you have. It doesn't matter what your salary is. When you come before God on judgment day, you'll be asked the question, what did you do with Jesus Christ? What did you do with my Son? What did you do with him? Did you believe in him? Did you trust in him? Did you believe in him as your Lord and Savior? That is the only way to flee from the wrath to come. There is a wrath of God coming. The wrath of God is coming for one day. There will be a day of judgment. There will be a day of reckoning. There will be a day when God calls all men to account. However great you are, however mighty you are, however politically correct you are, however religious you are, all of us will be called before Almighty God to give an account. And the only way to deal with the wrath and judgment of God, the only way to deal with that wrath and that judgment is to believe in the blood of Jesus Christ. For on the blood of Christ, when he died on that cross, the wrath of God came upon his own son. The wrath of God smote him. The wrath of God poured out upon his own son. And his own son was broken under the weight of the wrath of his father, because the Son of God was taking the wrath and the punishment for you. Every evil act that you've done, every wicked way that you've done, he died and took the punishment for you. The wrath of God fell upon his son. The wrath of the father fell upon his son. His son who knew no evil, his son who knew no wrong, his son who was pure and lovely and beautiful, his son who was kind, his son who was holy, who never ever did anything wrong, he died and took the wrath of God. And his father punished his son. My God, why have you forsaken me? And the wrath of the father was poured upon him for you. Every time you lie, every time you steal, every time you sleep around, every time you get drunk, every time you do something wrong, Christ took the wrath that you should have had. Instead of you going to hell, he took the hell for you on that cross. And there he knew no wrong, there he knew no lies, there on that cross he hung. And there he suffered in agony for you. You'll never know how much he suffered. You'll never know the pain that he went through. You'll never understand a holy God there punishing his own son on the cross for you. For you on the cross. For you on the cross. He died for you on the cross. Now every time you sleep around, every time you lie, every time you gossip, you put him on the cross. There he died for you. There he shed his blood for you. There he was broken for you on that cross. And Christ beckons you to come and be forgiven. He beckons you to come and be cleansed. He beckons you to come and be washed. To come and be washed of the Son of God. To be washed of the blood of Jesus. To be washed of Jesus. So you're saved from the wrath to come. Hitler will meet God. And when Hitler meets God, God will say to Hitler, depart from me, and in hell you will go. German now will meet God. And God will say to him, did you believe in my son? What did you do killing all these people? Depart from me and go to hell. And God will bring you before him. And God will say to you, did you believe in my son? And you can stand there and say, well, God, I was politically correct, and I didn't want to know about you, because I was politically correct. And God will say, no, did you believe in my son? Did you believe in my son? Did you believe in my son? It doesn't matter if you're a modernist, a postmodernist, a pluralist. It doesn't matter if you're politically correct. The only thing that can save you is the blood of Christ. The only thing that can save you is his blood. For he there shed his blood. The Son of God died and shed his blood that you may live. There, the blood of God was shed for you. The blood of God was shed for you on that cross. And if you want to be clean, if you want to be forgiven, if you want to be restored, if you want to know the living God, if you want to know the meaning to life, if you want to know why you're here, then go to that cross, for on that cross he shed his blood for you. Amen, sister, God bless you. He shed his blood for you. And you can put your hope in politics. And you can put your hope in spice. And you can put your hope in a relationship. And you can put your hope in a house. And you can put your hope in a pension. And you can put your hope in your salary. You can put your hope in your PhD. You can put your hope in science. You can put your hope in religion. You can put your hope in philosophy. You can put your hope in political correctness. But I put my hope in Jesus Christ. I put my hope in the Lord of Lords and King of Kings. I put my hope in Him, the Savior of the world, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. I put my hope in Him. Who do you put your hope in? Do you put your hope in your spice, in your porn, in your drugs, in your car, in your house? What do you hope in today? The world is going mad. We might have a war in Korea. We might have another big war that we've never seen before in the world today. But no, where is your hope? Where is your hope? The only hope is the blood of Christ. The blood of God shed for you. The blood of Christ shed for you. The blood of Christ given to you. That is the only hope. There he died and was crucified for you. He was crucified for you. Where will you go when you die? Where will you go when you die? What will you do when you die? Where will you go when you die? When you die, do you go to be with the worms? No. When you die, you come before Almighty God on the day of judgment. And on the day of judgment, God judges us. And what he will judge us on is, did we believe in Jesus Christ? Did we have faith in the Son of God? I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father but through me, he says. We switched it around and we said, no, we're so wise today. We're so wise. We're so politically correct. Well, your political correctness is taking you to hell and is destroying your own nation. Your political correctness is destroying the nation. It's crumbling the nation, and it'll also send you to hell. What you need is the blood of God. What you need is the blood of Christ. What you need is the Son of God who came down and died on that cross for you. Every time you love to lie, every time you love to steal, every time you love to sleep around, every time you love to get drunk, every time you love and cling on to these things, then you are clinging onto the road to destruction and clinging onto the road of hell. And what you need is the blood of the Lamb who shed his blood for you on that cross. The blood of God shed for you. The blood of God shed for you on that cross. That is the answer. Said Jay, oh, don't you understand, Jay? We're politically correct. Well, I'm telling you, my friend, is you're choking on your political correctness. Your political correctness is killing you and killing your nation. What we need is to come back to the blood of the Messiah. We need to come back to the blood of the Lamb. That's what we need. We need to come back to the blood of the Lamb. That is what we need today. The blood of Jesus Christ, who shed his blood for you on that cross. Amen. That is what we need today. We need a change of heart. We need to be born again. The days are over when you can be politically correct. The days are over. You need to decide whose side are you on. Are you on the side of the Lord? Or are you on the side of political correctness? Which side are you on? Which side are you on? Are you on the side of political correctness? Or are you on the side of the Lord? Whose side are you on? Are you on the side of Jesus Christ, the King of Kings? Or are you on the side of political correctness that will take you to hell? This nation is dying because it's politically correct. Well, God ain't politically correct. Jesus ain't politically correct. Okay? Political correctness is a man-made ideology to brainwash you. That is what political correctness is. Man-made ideology to brainwash you. The blood of God was shed for you. The Son of God shed his blood for you. That is what you need today. God's blood. Jesus Christ died.
It's all free, sir, if you want to take it. Just take whatever you want, sir. Just take whatever you want, bro. Anything else, sir? Anything else?
Okay.
DVDs are free, everything's free. Yeah?
God's blood was shed to set you free. God's blood was shed to set you free. The blood of God was shed for you. The blood of God was given for you. The blood of God died for you. The blood of God. All that God could have given, he gave for you. The blood of God. But you like your lies. You like your stealing. You like your sleeping around. You like it, all these things that God tells us not to do. You like it. And you love it. You love what this world is giving you, tickling your tummy and entertaining you. That is what the world is doing to you. The devil is corrupting you. The devil is blinding you and giving you what you want. But what you want is not what you need. What you need is the blood of Christ. The blood of God shed himself for you. The blood of God died for you. The blood of God was given for you. He was shed for you on that cross. And if you want hope, you want forgiveness, know that he died on that cross. Know that he shed his blood. Know that he gave his life. And whoever comes to him will have life. Whoever comes to him will have life. If you but come to him and look to him and have faith in him, you will have life. He will show you his love in the morning. He will show you his love at night. He will show you his love if you go to him. He is a Savior that loves you and wants to be with you. And he will show you his love if you let him into your life. Let him into your life and let him show you his love today. The love of God. The love of God. The love of God wants to come in. The love of God wants to fill you. The love of God wants to strengthen you today. And the love comes in Jesus Christ. The love comes in Christ the Savior, having faith in him. That is the love of God in Christ. The love of God in him. He will bless you as you trust in him. He will strengthen you in the midst of trouble. He will help you in the midst of the darkness. The Son of God, who knew no sin. If you put your faith in him and trust in him, he will help you and strengthen you and give you peace. He will fill you with his joy and power as you believe in him and be washed in the blood of the Lamb and clean in the blood of the Lamb, right in the blood of the Lamb. For the blood of the Lamb was shed for you. It was the blood of God. The blood of God shed his blood. The blood of God shed his blood for you. The blood of God shed his blood on a cross. That you may not go to hell. That he took your hell upon himself. That he took your wrath upon himself. That he took your judgment upon himself. That only cross, he hung, and he hung dying for you. He hung shedding his blood for you. He hung broken for you. That is what he did for you. He hung on the cross, broken for you. If you come to him and trust in him, you will be forgiven, and you will be cleansed, and you will be washed, and you will be clean in the blood of the Lamb. Yes, the blood was shed for you. The blood was given for you. The blood was broken for you. He died on the cross and shed his blood for you and you and you and you, each one. He loved you. Each one, he died for you. Each one, he gave his life for you. The blood of God. He died on the cross and shed his blood for you. Come to him. Come to him and know his love in your life. Don't walk in the way of the world anymore. Don't walk in the ways of the world anymore, but walk in the blood of the Lamb. Walk in the blood of Jesus. Walk in the grace of God. And know that he loved you. Know that he gave his life. Know that he shed his blood. Know that he died for you. Know that he was broken on the cross for you. Have you ever lied, sir? Have you ever lied? Instead of God punishing you for your lies, Jesus Christ died on the cross and took your punishment for you. He did, sir. He did. Have you ever looked at a woman in lust? Instead of God punishing you, sir, for your lust, Jesus Christ died on that cross for you. Have you ever been angry, sir? Never been angry. You just told me a lie there, sir. Jesus Christ died for your lies and for whatever you were angry, sir. He loved you, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes on him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. The blood of the Lamb was shed for you. The blood of the Lamb was given for you. He shed his blood for you on that cross and died for you on that cross. And if you trust him, you will find peace. You will find hope. You will find mercy. You will find grace. You will find peace in the midst of this world. The blood of Jesus Christ shed his blood. The blood of Jesus Christ was given for you. If you trust him, if you look to him, if you believe in him, if you serve him, if you have faith in him, you will be forgiven, and you will be cleansed, and you will be washed. I said, okay. Yes. From Adam and Eve, and it came from two apes, did it? They were two apes.
They
came from Adam and Eve. It came from Adam and Eve, sir. When Adam and Eve fell, yeah, it brought sin in, and they had children. But God later on, in the time of Moses, he made it a law